Today I'm wearing our old Soilworks greenhouse shirt because years ago we solved some problems and we brought in an expert on many different levels, Dr. Thomas Dykstra. No, that's you, buddy. Ooh. We brought in the expert to help identify and to clarify what we actually did, because at the time we didn't really know what we were doing. Dr. Thomas Dykstra is an expert on the refractometer. He has spent a career testing, understanding, and solving problems with the sugar content of BRIX. He's a PhD. He understands insects. He understands microbes. One question I've got to ask is, a lot of doctors go into academia. They go in with the big companies. You chose a tough path, cowboy.
I did.
Why?
I went in to become an independent consultant, an industrial entomologist, very different from academe, very different from the USDA, where most of the entomologists are employed. But the reason why I went into it and the reason why it was thrust upon me was because of Phil Callahan. So that was the turning point in my career. I started working with Phil Callahan. I got my PhD underneath Phil Callahan. This led into my first job. And this first job obviously was not associated with academia and the USDA.
Well, in your quest, in your journey of testing BRIX, have you found many diseases that cannot be stopped by increasing the BRIX or the sugar content of a plant?
There are absolutely, positively no diseases that cannot be stopped by increasing the BRIX.
Can you say that again and look right into the people that are watching? Look into their eyes.
You're much more attractive than the camera.
Work with me.
Oh. Actually, that is a beautiful camera. I take that back. The reason why we go into this is that when we have a high BRIX level, which is BRIX, when we have a high BRIX level, which corresponds to high sugar, we have a healthy plant. Healthy plants do not get sick. They do not find themselves being attacked by insects, and they do not find themselves being attacked by any fungi. Now, there are levels at which that happens, but when it's high enough, they're resistant to everything.
Okay, so going back to our research greenhouse, we dug into the hill. This is 15 years ago. We dug into the hill what we thought was pretty good soil, untouched by man, no chemicals, no synthetic fertilizers. We brought it in, dumped in the greenhouse, and we said, oh, we're going to start growing food. Oh, boy.
That's not what happened?
No.
Oh.
No, it's not. What we found is that soil had high bicarbs or bicarbonates. It had a high pH. Mm-hmm. And at the time, in 2009, it's just like, the heck is a bicarb and what is it doing there? And why are we having all these diseases? So we started thinking, being a calcium company, oh, well, we just need more calcium to control this problem.
Sure, sure.
And guess how that worked?
Did it work well?
No. It showed very little response. We've had wonderful success using soft rock phosphate, which had a different form of calcium, phosphorus, and trace minerals. We tried that, and guess how that worked?
Did that work well?
No.
Okay.
So we tried liquid fish fertilizer. Mm-hmm. Little response.
Oh, we got something.
So we tried biology, a lot of different forms of biology. Didn't see much. We were getting disease, we were getting weeds, we were getting problems, and we had low BRIX.
This story's getting really good. Let's stay.
Low BRIX being, what would you say? Quick number.
Low BRIX, 3.
Okay. What would a minimum, like 10?
A minimum for BRIX would be 4.
To be food.
Oh, to be food, 12. I would say minimum is 12. Okay. Yeah.
We were in that 3, 4, 5 BRIX range.
That's considerably lower than 10 and 12,
and
isn't
the plants showed it. Yeah. So we've got this grow right, it's like, boy, we're not growing it right. And R-I-T-E is more of a ritual than a correctness. So it's like, we've got to be ritualistic in doing something. So this took us quite some time. And what we found out is by adding carbon into the soil, it fed the microbes. Mm-hmm. And looking back, we didn't figure this out at the time, but the microbes started respirating, started partying, started reproducing, honeymooning. And as they're exhaling CO2 mm-hmm. and the water, H2O, you know what that formed.
CO2 with H2O is going to form an acid, carbonic acid.
Carbonic acid, which has a pH of between 4 and 5. Now, all of a sudden, the pH of our soil came down. And as the soil pH came down, guess what went up?
The BRIX.
You knew this one. I knew it.
I did. I saw it coming.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah. And the first thing we saw is the BRIX got up into the high single digits, 7, 8, 9. We saw problems going away.
They start to go away at about that point.
Yeah. What was actually happening internally? And we're not doctors here, so give us the
short reason. Once you get above 6, secondary plant metabolites come in. Once you get up to 10, you're really not going to have any fungus problems. Once you get up to 12, you're going to start producing food. Once you get up to 14, you're going to have no insects attacking, and you've really arrived at that point. Now, 14 is not the end all. You can certainly go higher than that,
yeah.
But 14 is pretty much the point where you can relax and exhale.
Yeah.
And say, I did a good job.
And what we saw is when we got to 7, 8, 9 BRIX, squeezing the leaf sugar with a penetrant or with a
garlic press.
Squeezing the leaf sugar
You're
with a garlic
welcome.
Press. Thank you. And we checked the BRIX, put a few drops on there. The prism of glass will bend the light and show how much sugar is in the solution from the plant juice mm-hmm. that we've squeezed out. When we got to 7, 8, 9 BRIX, the fungal diseases went away, the powdery white mildews, the phytophthoras, the rhizoctonias, the yep. pythiums, the verticillium wilt. We had all kinds of fungal diseases, and at that point in time, some of your words inspired me. It's just like, huh, raising the sugar content, the photosynthesis, is starting to stop problems.
What he's trying to say is, I'm in his head.
Sorry.
You're not.
So, and what happened is, as we continued our growth, mm-hmm. we got to 12, 13, 14 BRIX. And like you had said,
yeah.
we had white flies in the greenhouse up until that 12, 13, 14 BRIX. And Alice, our greenhouse manager, noticed dead white flies by a certain set of plants. She's like, oh. This is pretty cool. So she grabs the garlic press, she grabs this, and lo and behold, 13, 14 BRIX.
Mm-hmm.
So what you had said, and I want to get this right, there is no disease known to the plant kingdom that can't be controlled if you have a healthy plant high BRIX.
Yes, that is correct. No reservations.
Wow. Wow. So any of the fungal diseases, the bacterials, the virals?
Mm-hmm. All of them. None of them will be able to take hold.
So now at this point in time, we were doing Grow Rite. The research greenhouse showed us a lot of different things. And what was nice is we had a doctor, a PhD, to qualify what we were seeing and to move in the right direction. This is a short video to help growers realize that you don't have to count on a chemical. Chemicals are needed in times to stop the problem.
They're very helpful for low BRIX plants.
Yes.
Very helpful.
But that isn't where it ends.
Mm-hmm.
You want to start building so you don't keep reacting to symptoms.
Well, some people like to spend money.
Well,
yeah.
Okay. So, short version. Stopping diseases is as simple as what?
Measuring with a refractometer.
And?
And reaching a BRIX of 10 to 14, depending upon disease or insects. How am I doing?
You're doing fantastic. If you'd like to see more about Dr. Dykstra.
Or less.
he has videos giving in great detail what the refractometer does. I'm Glenn from SoilWorks. We appreciate you watching. Thank you.
Thank you.